Yeah, sir, we'll start. We at Charak welcome you all for this enlightening session on strengthening immunity the natural way, which is much needed during this scenario of COVID-19 outbreak. We have our very dynamic, holistic, energetic expert, Dr. Rupesh Amle. He is MD Ayurveda, who is here to throw light on the same and help us to strengthen our immunity to face this issue more strongly. We welcome Dr. Rupesh, and over to you, sir, for the enlightening session.
Hello, everyone. Thank you so much, Neeraj-ji. So, is it a green signal from you that shall we start?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Go ahead, sir.
Okay. So, hello, everyone. Good evening. Myself, Dr. Rupesh Amle. I welcome you all great doctors here in this live webinar organized by Charak Pharmaceutical. First, I would like to say thanks to the entire team of Charak Pharma, Mr. Neeraj, Mr. Jha, Mrs. Pooja, Mr. Yogesh, for inviting me as a guest speaker for this webinar. As well as, I would like to say thanks for providing such a beautiful platform for a doctor community over which we can communicate with each other and we can discuss today's burning issue, that is COVID-19, in this lockdown days. So let's start the presentation with the blessings of Lord Dhanvantari. And today's my presentation topic is strengthening immunity with Ayurveda. As everybody knows, current pandemic situation is due to COVID-19. So let's have a look over the statistics of coronavirus. So here we can see there are total 45,27,815 cases has been reported till date of coronavirus worldwide, and out of that 82,103 cases has been reported in India alone of coronavirus. So entire social media is promoting or spreading awareness regarding prevent or to control the coronavirus. And we always come across such kind of headlines like, if you are immunocompromised, you are at a higher risk of getting coronavirus. So what does this actually mean? See, every individual has got an immunity since birth, but that immunity is not going to remain the same level throughout our entire life. There are a lot of factors which affects our immunity status, like our wrong lifestyle, wrong dietary pattern, wrong habits like smoking and alcohol, and various lifestyle disorders like diabetes, cholesterol, blood pressure, thyroid, which affect our immunity status. And because of these lifestyle disorders and various risk factors, our immunity gets compromised. Our immunity gets exhausted. And with this compromised immunity status, we are nowhere. With this immunocompromised status, we are highly vulnerable to get any kind of infection, including coronavirus. So here, I can make an equation that if you are having low immunity status, there are more chances of getting an infection. So as you all know, till date, there is no definite treatment is available for the coronavirus. So what is the best tool that we can have to fight with this corona is only prevention. Yes, through prevention only we can fight with coronavirus. Now, how to prevent this coronavirus means we need to build our immunity. Immunity is the only weapon we have to fight with this corona. Now, how to build this immunity? Here comes the role of Ayurveda. Yes, Ayurveda is the only science which helps us to give, to nurture us with holistic immunity. Entire Ayurvedic community is familiar with the shloka, that is Samadosha, Samagni, Samadhatu Malakriya, Prasanna Atmendriya Manaha, Swastha Iti Abhidhiyate. This is the comprehensive definition of healthy person according to the Ayurveda. Holistic immunity means Ayurveda does not facilitate us only with the physical immunity. It helps us to give mental, social, and spiritual immunity also. So, as a person, we get immunity or a shield from all over the aspects of our life. And in a true sense, we can say that we are immune to get any kind of infection or any kind of disease. So here, I have justified the title of my presentation. Strengthening immunity is important to prevent the coronavirus. And to improve your immunity, to strengthen your immunity, the only tool or the only science which is going to help us is Ayurveda. Okay. So till now, everyone has understood. Am I audible, Mr. Neeraj?
Yes, yes, very much audible, sir.
Okay. So if in this presentation, I am going to share you some of the immunity boosting tips which will help you to upgrade your immune system. Now, what are those immunity tips? So before understanding those immunity tips, we need to understand the basics of immunity. So what are the basics of immunity? We need to go into a little bit of prevention and social medicine, that is the concept of infection. When there is an infection, then only immunity will come into the picture. But what is infection? So infection is any kind of bacteria, virus, fungus, parasite, or any kind of microorganism which will enter in our body as a host or as a parasite, and it will create an infection. So infection is basically pathogen. So this pathogen, we as a host and the environment, it is an epidemiological triad which creates a pandemic, or I can say epidemic. So what increases the chances of infection? Here I have presented one mathematical equation, that chances of infection is equal to virulence into number of microorganisms divided by host resistance. So let us solve this equation and let us understand it. What does it actually mean? So virulence means the strength or the pathogenicity of any microorganism. More the potent organism, more is the chances of infection. Obviously, if the number of microorganisms attacking a person is more, there are more chances of infection. And the last, that is host resistance, means our immunity power. If our immunity power is less, there are more chances of infection. So what we should do in order to increase our immunity and to reduce the chances of infection? So by this equation, it is very clear that if we want to reduce the chances of infection, we want to improve the host resistance. And it is only possible through immunity. So we need to improve our immunity to reduce the chances of infection. So we have to work at the two level. First, at the virulence level, and second, at the host resistance level. So here is the two level criteria to reduce the chances of infection. First, to reduce the strength and the number of organism. For that, what we need to do, we should stay at home, we should use mask, we should use sanitizer, and we should follow disciplines of social distancing. And to improve the host resistance, we need to develop a good immunity. So at this point, everyone must be agree with me that why immunity is so important in prevention of coronavirus. Yes. So whenever there is an infection attacking over us, it releases certain kind of immune response in our body. And to that response, body releases certain kind of molecules, cells, and tissues that participate in inducing immunity. And that entire system is called as immune system. Now here, to deliver immunity through Ayurveda, we need to understand the concept of immunity with the perspective of Ayurveda also. So what Ayurveda says about immunity? In Ayurveda, immunity is called as Vyadhik Shamatva. Vyadhi means a disease, and Shamatva means ability to overcome that disease. So in a simple language, I can say Vyadhik Shamatva can be defined as body's ability to fight any kind of disease. Vyadhik Shamatva, according to the classics, is defined as Vyadhi Utpada Pratibandhakaratva and Vyadhi Bala Virodhakatva. What does this actually mean? So Vyadhik Shamatva is a factor which prevents occurrence of the disease. And due to some unfavorable condition, if a person gets infected with that disease, then also that factor comes into the picture. It fights with the infection and makes the person disease free. So immunity is not only for the prevention of the disease, immunity is to fight with that infection also. So here at that point, I can say immunity is nothing but Vyadhik Shamatva. But Vyadhik Shamatva is a broad term, So we need to understand, or we need to dig this concept to go into the deep of the Vyadhik Shamatva. So what is actually Vyadhik Shamatva? So there are total 7 dhatus in our body. Every Ayurvedic person knows that there are total 7 dhatus in our body. And whatever food we eat, that is converted into Ahar Rasa. And from Ahar Rasa, respective Dhatu Agni acts over that Ahar Rasa and respective Dhatu is formed. Like first of all, from the Ahar Rasa, Rasa Dhatu will be formed. Then from Rasa Dhatu, Rasa Dhatu will be formed. Then there will formation of Mausa, Medha, Asti, Majja and Shukra. And afterwards, there will be formation of Oja. Essence of all 7 Dhatus, the cream layer, the richest layer of our Ahar Rasa, is Oja. And that is actually a factor which gives us Vyadhik Shamatva, that is immunity. Hence, I can say here, Oj is the essence of 7 dhatus in our body, and hence it is the seat of strength and plays vital role to induce immunity in our body. As it is lastly formed, hence it is called as Mala of Shukra also. Shukra Dhatu Mala is also called as like that. Ojas is of 2 types. According to the classics, Ojas is of 2 types, like Para Ojas and Upper Ojas. So Para Ojas is in quantity of 8 drops and Upper Ojas is in the quantity of half Anjali. And Para Ojas is located in the heart. So here, with the concept of immunity, Vyadhik Shamatva, and Para Ojas, this Para Oja is more important to consider as an immunity factor, which is located in our heart. So this Oj gives strength to our body. So there are 3 types of strength in our body. First is Sahaj Bal. Second is Kalas Bal, and third is Yuktikrut Bal. So let us understand each strength one by one. So what is Sahaj Bal? Sahaj Bal means some strength which we are having since our birth. That strength can be physical as well as mental. Both the strength are present in every individual. From where we are getting this strength, irrespective of our wrong lifestyle, wrong diet, some kind of strength is there in our body. And that is because of our excellency of Dhatu, or it is because of our mother and father, because they were having good quality or good healthy Shukra, and that is why genetically we are getting that strength, and that type of immunity is called as Sahaj Bala or Sahaj strength. Then Kalaj Bala. Kalaj Bala means the strength which we are acquiring as per the time. This strength is due to favorable conditions. Like suppose, according to the Ayurveda, there are 2 types of Kal, Adhan Kal and Visarga Kal. In Adhan Kal, nature absorbs strength from us, and in Visarga Kal, nature releases or gives strength to us. So obviously, every person is going to gain strength from the nature automatically in Visarga Kal. So that is nature gifted strength. That is Kalaj strength. Or I would say with another example, that every person has to go 3 stages of the life, that is Balya Avastha, Tarunya Avastha and Vruddha Avastha. So it is the Tarunya Avastha in which every person has a good strength or the maximum strength as compared to the Balya Avastha and Vruddha Avastha. So from where we are getting this strength, it is because of the effect of the Kal. So that is Kalaj Bala and Yuktikrut Bal. Here, please pay attention, this Yuktikrut Bal or this strength is more important, and we are going to induce immunity in our body with this concept of yuktikrut bala, that is acquired by intake of diet. That what type of diet we are eating, what type of lifestyle we are living, what type of habits we are doing, because of that, whatever strength we are getting, that is yuktikrut bala. So till now I have told you that immunity is a Vyadhik Shamatva. Vyadhik Shamatva is a factor which gives us immunity, is a strength, it gives bala, and as well as Oj is pran. Oj is also a pran. Ayurvedic classics describes Oj as Sarpivarna, Madurasa and Lajagandhi, and it is the Pranayatanam Uttamam. Among the 12 seeds of prana, Oj is the prime one. And here I can say immunity is nothing but, according to the Ayurvedic science, is a Vyadhik Shamatva also, is a Oj also, is a strength or the bal also, or pran also. So these are the synonyms, various different synonyms for immunity according to the Ayurvedic science. So now if we want to improve our immunity, means what we need to improve? Our Vyadhik Shamatva. Means what we need to improve? Our Ojas. From where Ojas we are getting? That is our strength. From where this strength is getting? From our Rasadi Dhatu. And from where we are, these Rasadi Dhatus are formed? From our diet. So in the last slide, I have told you that whatever food we are eating, that is Ahar juice is formed, Ahar Ras is formed, and respective Dhatu Agni will act over it, and respective Dhatu will. So all seven Dhatus essence is called as Oj, which is Vyadhik Shamatva, which is immunity. Now, if we want to improve our immunity, means we need to take good diet. So let me ask Ayurveda, is there any branch which deals only with immunity? So Ayurveda has Ashtanga. Ashtanga are there in Ayurveda. Which are those? Kaya, Bala, Graha, Urdhvanga, Shalya, Daunshtra, Jara and Vrsha. So in Ashtanga Ayurveda, there is a branch of Ayurveda which only deals with immunity. It is the huge umbrella of immunity. Lots of herbs are there in Rasayan category which can provide us, which can nourish us with the benefits of immunity. So Rasayan Tantra Namo Vayasthapanam Ayurmedha Balakaram Rogapaharanam Samarthecha. So with these Rasayana herbs, we are getting immunity, that is okay. Apart from that, what are the other benefits we are going to get? That it protects our youthfulness, it enhances our lifespan, it destroys the disease process, and in a way, Rasayana gives or maintains us holistically. So what are the different types of Rasayana are there? So there is Kuti Praveshik and Vatatpik type of Rasayana is there according to the Acharya Charak. So Kuti Praveshik Rasayana means it is a kind of Rasayana herbal treatment which we have to do under a strict diet and regimen restrictions. It is an indoor management and it is for a long time. Whereas Vatatpik is an outdoor management. As such, there are no strict rules which we have to follow, and in our day-to-day life we can use it. So here in this era, Vatatpik Rasayana can easily manifest or it can easily be given to all kind of people or in the entire community as a Rasayana. For example, Chavanprash we can advise to the patients. For example, golden milk we can advise to the patient. But let me ask you one question. In a community, there will be different kinds of people. For all kind of people, how can a simple or a single Chavanprash or golden milk will induce immunity? Is it possible? A person is diseased condition, a person is in a healthy condition, or a person is in a very child, young, old, everyone. If taking Chavanprash, will he able to induce immunity in his body? Nowadays, there is immunity is a $1 million industry. Everyone is asking about immunity boosting drugs, medicine, diet and everything. So here is the golden chance for all of us. If you want to become an immunity specialist, or if you want to develop yourself as a customized immunity advisor, you need to dig into the concept and you need to follow this concept thoroughly. So how your approach should be towards the community while advising or while treating the patients in the perspective of immunity? See, in the community, there will be two types of people. One who is already swastha person and the one who is already diseased condition. So let us take the example of swastha person. Swastha person means the one who is already having all his doshas, dhatu, agni, his all mala and everything at a normal level. His mind, body, soul all are intact condition. So he is already healthy. So we need to give him certain kind of rasayan dravyas which will take him to the path of healthiness. That is from healthy structure to more healthy structure. Healthy to healthiness. But in a diseased condition, first we need to treat that disease with the some medicine. First we should make that person from a diseased person to a healthy person. And then from healthy person, his pathway should be towards the healthiness. So this type of approach should be considered. So Sahita also says about it like this. According to the achievable outcome, there are three types of rasayanas. One is naimittik rasayana, other one is ajasrik or nitya rasayana, and third one is kamya rasayana. So naimittik rasayana is indicated only for those person who are in diseased condition. Let us take the example of diabetes, cholesterol, blood pressure, thyroid. Now in this 130 crore population of India, more than 45% people are having such kind of lifestyle disorders. So simply Chyawanprash or a sugar-free Chyawanprash cannot be an immunity modulator medicine for them. First of all, we need to treat them in as a disease, and then we need to give some kind of immunity booster drugs to them. Like Shilajitu for a diabetes patient, Trifala Rasayan, those who are having eye disorders, Ajamansa Rasayan, those who are having tuberculosis, and likewise. First, we need to identify their disease condition, their dhatu condition, and their body condition, their prakriti analysis, and on the basis of that, we need to advise them certain kind of rasayan dravyas. Then let's go to healthy person. Now he is a healthy person. He is already having all the things in an equilibrium. He is already having good health. But still, to improve his quality of life, to improve his healthy lifestyle, we need to give some kind of rasayan dravyas. Like for an example, we can advise them milk, ghee, honey, and certain good behaviors also. So let us take the example of ghee. So ajanma satmyam, milk description in Sanhita is called as ajanma satmyam. Ghee is the processed form of milk and it has variety of good effects over our body. As you can see in the slide, it improves the bone development, it helps to balance the weight, it provides nourishment, it promotes the digestion. It protects our arteries from atherosclerotic changes. It increases the bone density. It heals the wound. It promotes the healthy pregnancy. It improves the eye health. And ultimately, it improves the immunity. So there are myths and facts about the ghee. That ghee increases weight. Ghee increases weight. Or ghee is very bad for our body. There are some myths about ghee also. But the real fact is, ghee is very much beneficial for our body and it is the essential nutrient of our body. Here is the description or here is the varnan about ghee mentioned in our classics. Ghee is called as rasayanam, ghee is medhyam, ghee is balyam, stanyakaram, shrama, brahma, mada, lakshmi, shvasa, kasa, atitrut, shudha. So in all kind of condition, you can advise patient to take ghee. So what should be the quantity of that ghee? 1 or 2 tablespoon during the meal or in between meal. What is kamya rasayan? So in a community, you can find another kind of people who wish or who having a desire to develop something specific immunity in their body, like childhood age. In this age, many of the mothers complained about that lack of concentration is there, memory power is not good. So in that condition, we can tell them that Medhya Rasayanas are there. Then to improve the quality of the prana, Prana Kamya Rasayanas are there. To improve the lifespan, Ayush Kamya Rasayanas are there. To improve the healthiness of our eyes, Chakshusha Rasayanas are there. As I have said, that Oj or the Vedic Shamato or immunity is the essence of all seven dhatus. So after analyzing patient's prakriti or after analyzing his body's dhatu status, we can analyze which dhatu is in depletion condition, and according to that dhatu we can give some medicine to them so as to promote the digestive fire of that particular dhatu. Like suppose if it is rasa dhatu, we can advise them draksha. If it is rakta dhatu, we can advise them amalki. For mausa dhatu, ashwagandha is there. For medha dhatu, guggul is there. For asti dhatu, shukti bhasma is there. For majja, shankhapushpa is there. And for shukra, kapikachhu is there. So these herbs is having prabhavi effect over that particular dhatu, and they will improve the quality of that particular dhatu, and at the same time they will have aphrodisiac effect as well as ojovardhak effect in our body. Simply giving good diet, simply giving good herbs to them will not solve the immunity issue. Immunity is a multi-dimensional approach. If a person is having good diet, he is taking medicine on time, but if his lifestyle is not good, that thing is not going to improve his immunity. So for that, we have Achar Rasayana. So what is Achar Rasayana? Means it is a correct or modified way of lifestyle which we have to follow to get or to absorb real benefits of these Rasayana Dravyas. So in this, a mass education to be given to the entire society in order to strengthen immunity with Dincharya, with the principles of Dincharya, Rutucharya and Ratricharya. So how our day should be? So in our daily routine, Brahma Muhurta, we should get up at Brahma Muhurta. So you will ask me, sir, with simply getting up at Brahma Muhurta, how we are going to increase our immunity? See, Brahma Muhurta Uttishtetu Swastha Rakshartham Ayusha, it is a time-tested proven quotation given by Acharya Charak. Means simply getting up at Brahma Muhurta will activate your channel, will activate your dosha system in your body. It will channelize from your parasympathetic nervous system to sympathetic nervous system. And definitely it will open up the channel to grab more immunity in your body. After that, Danta Dhavan, Gandush, Kaval, Anjan, Nasya, Vyayam, Udvartan, all kind of daily routine procedures we have to follow, which we are not following in today's modern era. We should give equal importance to this daily regimen, and we should make them as the part and parcel of our day-to-day life to adapt or to grab more benefits of immunity. Now this was about physical immunity. Many people nowadays are having stress, and because of that stress, even though everything is normal, they are having good diet, they are following good income, all dimensions of the life are good, but they are having stress, so they cannot enjoy life. So yoga samatvam uchyate. So to balance your body and the mind, you need to follow the principles of yoga. It will whatever immunity you are getting through rasayanas and herbs, it will transfer that immunity to your mental level also, and mentally also you will be strong enough. Suppose this stress is what? It is a kind of infection to your mind. So do we have any kind of medicine to combat that infection or to fight with that infection? So yes, yoga is this. Yoga is there. So yoga will become as a shield over your mind, and it will help you to protect from you, protect from stress. So here some of the best yogasanas which you can practice in your day-to-day life to build your immunity. Your yogasana practice should be start with sukshma vyayam, which will help you to improve the blood circulation in every parts of the body. Then mild yogasanas, and then advanced yogasanas which requires more flexibility of your body. While considering all these factors, Agni should be considered, means our digestive fire. There are 13 Agni in our body: Pancha Bhautika Agni, Sapta Dhatu Agni, and Jathara Agni. If our Agni is in normal condition, then whatever the Ahar Dravya, whatever Aushadhi Dravya, whatever yoga we are doing, we can digest it well, we can absorb it well. So to improve this digestive fire, we should always engaged in activity that how we can improve our digestive fire. Because this digestive fire is going to digest whatever things you are eating, whatever things you are getting, in a proper way, and ultimately it is going to give you the best benefits out of it. Ahar, Nidra, and Brahmacharya, these are the three pillars of our life. If a person is not given food for 15 days, he can lie. If a person is not given water for 15 days, he can be alive. But if a person is not given sleep for 15 days, he will become mad. So sleep is that important. So while sleeping, our parasympathetic nervous system gets activated, and continuously engaged sympathetic system gets relaxation. So body needs relaxation. So when we are going bed, at that time our body is in exhausted condition. But when we are coming out of the bed, we should be in an energized condition. Nowadays people are complaining, the sleep quality is not good, sleep quantity is not good. Before sleep, people are using WhatsApp, Facebook, mobile, continuously screen they are using. And because of that, brain is not getting proper relaxation. And ultimately, it is affecting their immunity. Immunity means immediately they will not going to get any kind of serious disease. Common day-to-day life issues they will get. And in a way, they are hampering or they are reducing the strength of their immunity. Now, to improve or to maintain your level of immunity, you need to have 7 to 8 hours sound sleep or undisturbed sleep. What this sleep actually does? So sleep actually releases some kind of hormones in your body, releases some kind of enzymes, some kind of digestive juices, and releases some kind of things in your body which helps to build immune system properly. It helps to update your body. It helps to rejuvenate your body. So give much importance in your daily routine to the sleep also. In entire Ratri Charya, we have listened that sleep is very important in order to build your immunity. Seasonal purification. Purposely we are ignoring this fact that a simple vessel which is in impure condition, means suppose today, till today I was following unhealthy lifestyle or unhealthy practices, and from tomorrow onwards if I decide that I will do healthy practices, body is not going to get good effects. For that I need to cleanse my body. So how to cleanse your body? So Ayurveda says there is panchakarma to cleanse your body. So what are those panchakarmas? Vaman, Virechan, Basti, Nasya, and Raktamokshan. So in month of March, we can go for Vasantik Vaman. In month of September, we can go for Sharadiya Virechan. And in month of July, we can go for Varsharutu Basti. So these three things will help to remove the excess of dosha in our body, to remove the excess of toxins in our body, and helps to normalize body helps to normalize our dosha and helps to build our immunity. So disease specific rasayanas are there also. That is Vardhaman Pipali Rasayan and Bhallatak Rasayan. It also helps to improve your immunity. Now here comes the vital role, that is diet or Ahar Rasayana. The quotation is, if the diet is wrong, medicine is of no use. And if the diet is correct, medicine is of no need. We hear on social media, green vegetables are good, fruits are good, water is good for us, and we start taking it. But along with Ahar Rasayana, we should follow the principles of Ahara also. So in Ayurveda, there are 12 Pravishan Vicharas are there. That is Ushnam, Snigdham, Matravat, Jirne, Jirne, Tanmana, Bhunjita, Atmanam, Abhisamiksham. Means what? We should eat on a proper time with a proper quantity. We should analyze ourselves that whatever thing or whatever food we have taken last and whether it is digested or not digested, we should analyze our mala, whether our digestive system is good or not, and we should avoid viruddha ahara, incompatible food substances. Due to evolution in diet industry, there are a lot of combinations are available nowadays which may not be conducive to your body, and instead of giving good effects to your body, it is going to hamper your immunity status. So be very much specific about your diet. Self-analyze your body. And based on the correct principles of diet and nutrition, develop your diet pattern, develop your diet routine. Then Dravya Rasayan. Here I have made one list that according to the age, we can prescribe some of the rasayana herbs to the community. That if the age is between 1 to 10 years to that childhood age, we can give Vacha and Swarna Bhasma. 11 to 20 years, we can give Ashwagandha and Bala. For 21 to 30 years, Amalaki and Loha Bhasma. 31 to 40 years, Shankhapushpi and Jyotishmati. 41 to 50 years, Brungaraj and Priyal, Jyotishmati. 51 to 60 years, Trifala and Shatavari. 61 to 70 years, Kapikachu and Bala. 71 to 80 years, Amalaki. 81 to 90 years, Brahmi. And 91 to 100 years, Bala and Ashwagandha. So this is age specific rasayan herbs that we can prescribe to that particular age, because every age demand is different. Every age body's demand is different, body's requirement is different. So accordingly, we should be very much specific in order to prescribe the immunity herbs to the community. Even though after maintaining such principles, still because of climatic changes, still because of some kind of habits, if you are getting low immunity status and you are getting some kind of infections in your body, like lower respiratory tract infection, upper respiratory tract infection, skin infections, or pyrexia of unknown origin, viral infection, or any kind of infection, don't directly jump to a conventional treatment. So what is the conventional treatment? So nowadays we can see in a community, people, those who are having throat infection, directly go to the medical and they will ask for an azithromycin antibiotic. Those who are having urinary tract infection, they will go and ask for a norfloxacin antibiotic. So people are directly jumping on the antibiotics. So as a doctor, it is our social responsibility to avoid misuse and overuse of antibiotics, because these antibiotics has become resistance in the community, resistance amongst in treating the infection. What are the adverse effects of it? First of all, it is going to be higher medical cost for a particular or for a simple issue. It is going to fail the treatment protocols. It is going to increase your hospital stay, and ultimately a huge antibiotic resistance will develop mortality rate So directly don't jump to an antibiotic selection. So to conclude, now I can say improving immunity is a multidimensional approach. So simply taking up a single herb and addressing the community that you should take this herb or take this medicine as an immunity booster can be a wrong thing. So we need to deliver holistic immunity to the entire community in the form of daily regimen, night regimen, seasonal regimen, yoga, exercise, nourishing diet, and Rasayana herbs. While treating to the entire community, we fail to give attention to ourselves. Of course, as a doctor, we are the first line of soldiers to fight with any kind of infection. You can be a clinician, you can be a physician, or you can be a hospital doctor or a surgeon. At the same time, continuously, you are exposed to any or the N number of infections. So at the same time, you should maintain your immunity to the optimum level. So thoroughly, use warm water for a drinking purpose with some kind of immunomodulator herbs like tulsi we can use, pipli we can use, dalchini we can use, jeera we can use, sunta powder we can use. So make a decoction of all these herbs and drink twice in a day in your day-to-day life. Chyawanprash or any kind of rasayana herb as per your prakruti, as per your analysis of your body constitution, you should prescribe to yourself and start taking that. Golden milk, of course, it is a time-tested and proven thing which improves our immunity. If you are having some or the other kind of issues, lavang churna with honey also will help you. So I mean to say here that as a doctor, we should take care of ourselves in improving immunity. As a social responsibility, Charak Pharma has also taken an initiative to deliver two products as a contribution to an immunity modulator. And the first product is Immu Build by Charak Pharmaceutical. It is available in tablet and syrup form. The tablet dose is one tablet thrice a day, and syrup dose is for adult 10 ml twice a day. For children's 5 ml twice a day. So what is this? What this Immu Build contains? So some of the good rasayana herbs like guduchi, amla, pipli, chitrak, manjishta, and haridra. The combination of all the drugs which can improve your digestive fire, which can improve your ahar rasa quality, which can improve your dhatuvagni fire, which will help you to develop good amount of or good dhatus. Ultimately, from that good dhatus, you can develop good ojas, and that ojas is a factor which gives strength to the body. And what is that strength? That is the immunity. So ultimately, immunity is going, you are going to get it through the excellency of the dhatus. If we are quite enough, or if we are take a good diet in terms to develop our quality of our dhatu, ultimately we are going to get good immunity for our body. And the second product is Vigorol, which contains avla, suntha, chitrak, pipli, guduchi, and akarkara. So here suntha, chitrak, and pipli is a good digestive fire enhancer. Avla and guduchi is having good antioxidant. So avla and guduchi has an oxidation stress reducing property. It scavenges free radicals from the body. And once the free radicals are out of the body, we can delay the aging process also. And it is also a part of immunity boosting activity. Akarkara is having effect of over our reproductive system as well as over our brain, and helps to improve sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system also. So to conclude this entire session, I would like to say one quotation that disease management is costly and painful, whereas health management is free and enjoyable. Now we can see the disease management means now what the entire country or the entire world is managing coronavirus with the huge cost. Whereas, how to improve your immunity with just following the simple regimens like daily regimen, Ratricharya, Rutucharya, and simple principles of yoga and exercises to develop your health. So it is free and it is enjoyable also. You need not to take any kind of medicine. You need not to be in hospital. You just simply at home and you can enjoy those things. So ultimately, I would like to say Rasayana has definitely a role in prevention of disease and strengthening immunity. And it is only possible through Ayurveda. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Rupesh Amle. Now we can take the question answer session. Any doctor who has got an query can now ask questions from Rupesh Amle. He is there to really address it.
The session is open for the question and answer. If you have any doubts or the queries regarding the immunity concept, you can ask me.
Sir, one question has come. Dr. Rupesh, one question has come in the chat what should be the whether sugar should be added to the golden milk or not, and how many times this should be taken in a day?
See, the person who is going to take the golden milk, if he is a diabetic patient or he is not able to control his sugar level or the blood sugar level, then the sugar should not be added in that milk, first of all. And second, in a day, only once we need to take that golden milk.
Okay. Okay, okay. Any more questions from the doctor? No. Okay, sir. Thank you very much, Dr. Amle, on solving the queries and throwing light on such an important session. Thank you all doctors for giving your valuable time and attention here. Charak Pharma is always just a ping away. Please call or message us. My team is always there to support you. We are always at your service. Thank you on behalf of our head office team and my entire region. Thank you very much, sir. And thank you very much to all doctors.
Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor, sir.